How many of you have ever thought about this question? How much of influence can one person have on this world? Well, if you are Gandhi or Buddha, then your influence can spread across generations, over thousands of years, touching the lives of billions of people. That is what drives me. That is what guides me to go beyond myself and leave some positive footprints on history. Good morning, fellow travelers of this world. Today I'm here to share my history and something about my future. My journey started some 50 years back in a small town of Andhra Pradesh, which is famous for chilies. That's right, good tour. So I was born in an army family, typically strict father, gentle mother, big bully brother, and a little helpful sister. I'm going to describe the rest of my journey in three parts: age of learning, age of earning, and age of giving. Now my age of learning was spread across different towns and cities, being a part of the army family. But in sixth class, my father did a good thing by putting me into a hostel at a Senic school, Korukunda, which is near Vizag. And the best things I remember about the school, it got nothing to do with geography or history or trigonometry. Rather, the best things were friends, pranks, games, and most of all, plucking mangoes from the trees in the campus. Now, army being in my blood, soon after school, I joined the National Defense Academy, and there I realized how difficult it is to get through even 24 hours of army training. They put you in a mixer grinder and press the button and it goes on for 24 hours, 365 days, 4 years. But I did survive. In 1987, I passed out as a lieutenant, joined the army. So when you get your first job, your age of earning begins. And that's where my age of earning began in 87 at the age of 20. The army was an actual roller coaster ride. One day you are sitting in Rajasthan, sweltering, 50 degrees centigrade. Some other day you are sitting in Siachen Glacier, bone chilling, cold, minus 50 degrees centigrade, where each day is tough to survive. And having been through so many life and death situations, I actually don't fear death anymore. It doesn't bother me. Rather, having been through the situations helped me look at life in a more meaningful way. The value of each day. And what I realize, do your best, give your best, and forget the rest. Doing 21 years in the army, I realized that there is a world beyond which I need to explore. So in 2008, after doing 21 years, I jumped across the army cantonment walls into the civil world. And that's where my age of giving began. Now, when does the age of giving start? The day you feel that you have enough and now it's time to give back. The day you feel that you don't need to chase one more car or one more flat or one more gadget. It's time to give. There's so much we can give. You can give a smile, you can give a help, you can give a speech, you can donate blood, you can donate money, you can donate time. There's so much. We don't have to be Bill Gates to donate, to give. So me and my sister, we were in Delhi, we set up an institute called Transition. And in the next 8 years, we did soft skills, life skills programs for over 30,000 students across various NGOs, schools, universities, colleges. That gave a great satisfaction. 2 years back, I shifted here to Hyderabad, being my permanent place of residence. And I also shifted into another field, that is health and wellness. And now I help people to be healthy and happy through one-on-one consultations and doing corporate wellness programs to motivate people to be healthy. As far as my family life is concerned, people say that either you can be happy or married. I'm happily married for past 25 years. And my wife is a teacher, now dabbling in theater. My daughter, only daughter, is working in the field of website and graphic designing. And what are the things which are close to my heart? One is music. Music always keeps buzzing in my brains and veins. So I like to listen, I like to sing. I can sing anything from Jagjit Singh to Arijit Singh. And like to go for some TV show maybe in the next 2-3 years. I like running. After leaving the army, I upscaled from 5 kilometers to 10 kilometers, from 21 kilometers to maybe 42 kilometers marathon in Bombay. The third thing which is close to my heart is Toastmasters. I've been part of this system for over 8 years now, and I plan to stick around thanks to the dynamic environment here for at least next 80 years. And the timer is surely showing me the warning cards now. And I know someday I'll get a red card from there too. But till the time I'm here, I know what to do. Do the right, burn bright, and spread the light.